Good evening and welcome to the winter preview of the Bulldog Beat. Along with Dave Jones, Anthony Bachman, and Rob Schultz, I'm Nick Macri. We begin tonight with the boys basketball team, who after having a 14-13 record last year, hopes to go to the state tournament and Bergen County Jamboree. The senior-laden team is ready to kick off the season with a number of starters from the last few years. In the starting lineup, this team has a chance to be great. Brian Gashion is the coach of this team and hopes to lead this team to great success.
We looked pretty good tonight, but so far in the preseason, we were a little slowed with injuries. Obviously, the injury to Calb is going to hurt us. Jamie's been a little slow coming back, getting healthy. So today was the first time, you know, that we had our lineup in, you know, with the exception of Calb. I tell you, we've been building this thing since these guys were in eighth grade. So, I'm excited in the fact that we have nine seniors. All nine are capable of playing. We're going to rely on playing all seniors. We're going to start five seniors, and we're going to come in off the bench with seniors. So I'm real excited for the season.
We'll get into the Jambo. We didn't last year. Get home state games. Maybe win a sectional. And win the league.
So far, practice has gone well. We've been a couple injuries a little bit. Calb's out for a little while. I was hurt for a little while. Team started off a little slow, but now everyone's coming back, so we're looking good.
Mark Leonard, Jared Hulzer, Dennis Ackerman, and Jeff Arizano are the main players on the team. Many of them have been playing together since fourth grade, and this is their year to shine, hopefully on top of the BCSL American.
Well, we talked about three goals. We want to contend for a conference title. That means, be in the top three with a chance to win a conference banner. We also want to make the Bergen County Jamboree, which we would need to go 10-5 before the cutoff. And finally, we want to play state home games. And when I mean that, I mean we want to get a high enough seed in the Group 2 tournament to play state home games.
So it's probably the biggest game of our lives. Hopefully we're going to win, go 7-0 until we play QP. It'll be the big game.
Myself, just have a good season. Hopefully a lot of coaches can come watch me, do good in front of them, and just win as a team. Win state, win leagues will be good.
Two players coming off football are Dennis Ackerman and Kevin Segg, who looks to come off the bench. And the team's working hard to prepare for the season.
Well, you got to look at Ridgefield Park, you got to look at Westwood, and you got to look at Queen of Peace. They have a bunch of transfers. I think Englewood, ourselves, and Fort Lee is that next tier. To break into that top three, obviously, you have to win on the road in our conference, and you got to defend your home court.
Our goals are to get state home games, most importantly, get in the Jambo, and to win the league.
One player the Bulldogs hope to get back this year is Jamie Parnafiello, but he's hurt to start the season, but he looks to come back in a week or so. Rob Keller is going to have to take his place and lead the point, and he did a nice job filling in last year. Coach Gash to have a successful year. And the leading scorer for the Bulldogs will be Jared Hulzer, who aims at 1,000 points for his high school career.
I've been here last year. I played sophomore year. I sat the bench. Finally here. We've been waiting for this for a long time. Ever since freshman year, we've been talking about this, and here it is.
Yeah, it could. But the one thing we got to keep in mind: we went 14-13 last year, and our league got better. Across the board, the top five teams in the league are real good. So our expectations again are high. But I know the conference as a whole is going to be real good.
With senior leadership and tough defense, this team could go far in the county and state tournaments.
Friday can't come fast enough. I was just telling everybody, you know, senior year, your high school season, a lot of our guys are not going to play in college, so a chance to play, you know, in your senior year could be special.
So, Schultz, a big part of this team is the senior leadership.
That's right. With 9 seniors on the team, they hope to attain all the team goals that they set in the preseason.
Dave, in the highly competitive BCSL American, winning home games is truly the one key to winning the league outright. What makes Rutherford's home court truly an advantage?
Well, you know, besides having a pretty good team every year, we always have a couple of good players. The one thing that Rutherford does have every year is a great student section support. And the student section, as they're known as the Dog Pound, are 2-time fans of the year in Bergen County, always bring a high energy to the game, and also they make some trips to away games, and they always cheer on the Bulldogs, make sure they come out on top. After a 21 season and a trip to the Bergen County Tournament and State Sectional Final, the Lady Bulldogs are looking to improve on last year's success.
The 2006-2007 Lady Bulldogs are looking to have another successful season. Coach DeBarry at the helm is looking to improve this year's squad day in and day out.
Practices have gone well. Kids are playing hard, learning. Younger kids are getting involved, so we're real happy with practice so far.
It's cool, I guess. Well, like, it's a little nerve-wracking because it's your last year and you want to get everything right, but for the most part, like, it's fun because, you know, the girls are great and everything. So
to go undefeated in the leagues and hopefully win a state championship, maybe a league title, county title.
Sophomore sensation Tara Wooten is looking to step up this year and improve her scoring and rebounding ability. Tara has worked hard in the offseason to improve her game. Junior captain Jackie Mann is looking to step up and be a leader on this young Bulldog team. She is one of the top players to watch in North Jersey and will provide a majority of the scoring and rebounding for the Lady Bulldogs this year.
It's been good. It's not as like gruesome as it usually is, but still, like, still come in, work hard, get better. That's the goal.
I'm just to get better, hopefully score my 1,000.
We expect to win a league. We expect to make it back to the sectional final and win it this year, and we expect to go deep into the county tournament.
After starting to play a lot more towards the end of last year, Veronica Gore will be the number one defender and will look to shut down the likes of Alyssa May and Amber Duran this year. Freshman backup point guard Nicole Leonard will step up and play the role that Brynn O'Keefe played last year and looks to provide a spark off the bench.
I'm really excited. We're going for state sectional championship, baby. That's where we're going.
There's a bit of comfort in that, but at the same time, we lost a lot of players from last year, so we're putting new kids in to positions that were occupied by kids that had a lot of experience last year. So, you know, that's a good thing. But the flip side of it is that we do have other spots where we have younger kids.
Yeah, it feels like the same. Like, I don't know. It's just basketball. It's my life. I'm used to it.
Okay. Stepping into the starting lineup in her senior year, Regal Davis will provide toughness on both ends of the floor. Point guard Brittany O'Keefe looks to step in for her sister Gia. The 1,000-point scorer will provide leadership on and off the floor. Sophomore Lindsay Simone will look to provide a spark off the bench in this, her first varsity season.
It's been interesting. It's not like as hard as it usually is, I guess because you're expecting it now. But we definitely get good scrimmages in and definitely good practice.
You know what, I got to tell you, man, they've all been giving such a great effort. You know, I'm thrilled with all of them. You know, you're only as good as your weakest kid. And the effort that the best kid in the gym's given us, and, you know, the youngest kid the gym has given us has been fantastic. So we're thrilled with all of them right now.
And how excited are you for the start of the season?
I can't wait. Opening day this Friday.
Yeah. This year's team is young, but with hard work and dedication, they should look to contend for both a league title and a state sectional.
Oh, I'm fired up. Real fired up. You know, Friday can't come quick enough. You know, you see me pacing on Friday in the hallways. Trust me.
Dave, how will the team make up for the losses of point guard Gia O'Keefe, who scored 1,000 points, and Meg Murphy?
Well, the Bulldogs are going to have to look to improve in several areas with those. We need Gia's sister, Brittany, to step up and hopefully play a similar role in what Gia did in her career. And in addition, they still have Jackie Mann back for her junior year and Taylor Wooten for her sophomore year, who are two of the top players in North Jersey and spent a lot of time playing in the offseason. So the future looks bright for RHS.
And that's the interesting thing about this team, is that we talk about this being a team that can win this year, but they're still a young team compared to so many other teams in the league.
Yeah, you know, as you compare them to the likes of Riverdale, Ridgefield Park, you know, they're still a young team, and it's good that Coach DeBarry has these young girls, because not only can they win this year, but they can win for the next several years.
The weather outside is getting colder, but the action inside the pool is heating up. Let's dive in with the swim team.
The boys and girls swim team hope to be a contender for a league title.
They're improving every day in practice. We're a young team, especially on the boys' side, and that by the end of the season, I would expect a totally different outlook than what we're looking at right now.
Team looks great. We got a big win on Tuesday. Today's going to be our second meet, and we're going to look for another win.
Personal goals is to drop time in my main event, which is 200 freestyle, so I think that's good.
The boys' team is led by junior In-Soo Kim, sophomores Steven Crisati, and sophomore Mike Lazzaro. The girls' team is led by seniors Jen Kravitz, Kirsten Summer, and Kay Murphy, and juniors Michelle Dunn and Liz Berry.
I'd say all the athletes practicing. It's not just one, it's all. It's the whole team.
Right now, I'd say the whole team has pretty good focus in practice. We're training pretty hard over the holiday break. I think we'll see who at that point has the nerve to step up, because practice gets a lot harder during that time.
My personal goals, I hope to, you know, get better at backstroke. I'm not good at it. I'm swimming it this year. Okay. Really nerve-wracking. And get better at butterfly, you know, do better in general.
My personal goals are to qualify for the Meet of Champions and maybe break the 100 back record here.
As a team, we need to work harder together, because, as I said, we don't have that many people, so we need to work more as a team rather than individuals.
Riverdale, Tenafly, and Harrison are one of the few teams that will travel to Rutherford to compete against the Bulldogs.
That's Pearson, I guess.
Both of the team. I hope we go to States this year, because we've never been there, haven't been there in 20 years. So I'm hoping our fast rail I go to States this year.
The team's looking pretty good this year. I mean, we have a little less people than last year, but I think we'll be good for next year and this year.
As a team, I think we'll win leagues this year, both boys and girls. I'd hope we could go undefeated this season. It's going to be good.
Okay. Team looks good. Everybody looks fast. Everybody's doing good.
As always, I expect us to win. I think they expect that from themselves. And if we produce the way I think we're capable of, then a championship at the end of the year is what we're looking at.
Who has stepped up the most in practice?
Probably the freshmen this year, because there's not that many of them, and we need, as I said, we need to work more as a team. So stepping up as the freshmen to work really hard in practice, do the meets.
Okay, thank you.
With the experience and youth from last year, the Bulldogs hope to build a very successful program for years to come.
stepped up the most. I'm going to go with Liz Barry because, you know, she used to not be so fast, but, you know, not to be mean, but she's awesome now. You know, she's rock solid, so she's doing a lot better. She's fast.
It's a brand new league, although we've been swimming these teams for a few years now. We've now combined into a league. I think it will be fairly competitive. Of course, you know, Riverdale, New Milford, they're combined together, and they're always, for us, the team right now that has to be beat.
Rob, how does that boys' swim team look?
Well, Anthony, the team is composed of 10 underclassmen, and with the talent of Yensu Kim and Mike Lazaro, they hope to build a successful season.
Schultz, how are those girls looking?
Well, Dave, with the senior leadership of Kirsten Sauer, Jen Kravitz, and Kay Murphy, they hope to repeat as the league meet champs and hopefully contend for a league championship.
Last year's wrestling team was a slight drop-off from a previous Group 1 county championship, but looks to make a major improvement and climb back atop the BCSL American.
Here's a typical day in the Rutherford Wrestling Room where we're doing cartwheels and warming up for a hard. Here's Coach Rehan, who last year achieved 100 career victories.
Well, our team has been practicing good 2.5-3 hours every day. We've had about 3 scrimmages with all different teams, so we're looking to improve a lot since last year.
It's all right. A lot of pressure. Because everyone's looking up to you and everyone wants you to do good and everyone's cheering for you. And it's kind of hard because it's an individual sport. It's not a team sport. So.
Very exciting. I've kind of known Anthony and been coaching him since he was a second grader. And, 10 years have gone by and he's done a super job but still has some things that he'd like to accomplish and I'd like to see him accomplish those things.
Here's junior co-captain Rafa Cannon drilling with Coach Mike Blanchard. He looks to step in a big spot and fill in for a few lost seniors.
This season I'm going 125. I got down for the hydration test on Sunday, but I'm a little bit over now, so I'll be down for the Kearney tournament on Saturday.
Junior Jesse Kolich and sophomore Brian Brown both look to have tremendous seasons this year to help out the team.
It feels good to be a senior because, you know, we got a lot of freshmen this year, so they're kind of looking up to me and kind of follow what I do.
I can't wait for it to start. Practice is getting old. We need to get this get it started.
The wrestling coaching staff consists of head coach Jeff Rehane, who gives the instructional detail here. Here's Nick Hughes, who is the hands-on individual coach. He has all the techniques, and here he is demonstrating on assistant coach Mike Blanchard, who will also help in the practice room.
We'll do all right. We have a full lineup, so we should do pretty good.
I went to the regions, had a difficult loss. Ever since after that, I've been training hard, go running, lifting, doing all that stuff like practicing, going to camps and stuff like that, just to prepare for this season. And I think I'm going to have a good season this year.
Well, last year we were only like 6-14, so this year we're looking to be, you know, over 500.
We got a lot of new guys. We got about 10, 15 freshmen that never wrestled before, but it's a good program to start out with. Eventually we'll teach them what to do, and if they can get their like friends to join, so it'll be good.
It's been tough. Well, I've been going to like off-season like clubs and stuff, so.
Here's Nick Zerla and Gerardo Godoy, who will be anchoring the heavyweights for the bouts this season.
Well, you know, Anth is the one guy that's been around full-time. Our only other seniors are kind of new wrestlers that just picked it up last year. We got Gerardo and Pat Raines and his friend John Peralta. So we don't really have too many seniors that have a lot of wrestling experience. We're mostly underclassmen.
I can't wait for the season to start because it's been a long off season and I just want to get back on the mat.
The wrestlers are working hard. We a lot of the kids came off their fall sports, soccer and football, and so most of them are in decent shape already, and we're working hard getting ready for the first match.
Team looks to have a solid season this year and hopefully make it over 500.
I'm very realistic. I know that our team does not have enough experience to be a very good team, but we do have some wrestlers that are super wrestlers, and our goal is to have those guys accomplish as much individual success as they possibly can.
Anthony, what are some goals you're looking to achieve this year, both as a team and as an individual?
Well, team-wise, I'd really like to get a 500 record back because, having a 6-14 record last year and not making the state tournament, it was a little rough. Personally, I'm looking to get my 100th career win this year to become the third wrestler in Rutherford High School to get do that. And, of course, the number one goal is to win a state championship.
And now on to bowling. Dave, how's the team look?
Bowling!
Well, the bowling team is looking to improve on last year's fourth place finish in the BCSL American and be one of the top two or three teams and hopefully contend for a league championship this year. All right. And now on to boys indoor track. Nick, how's the team going to do this year?
Dave, they look pretty good, and the interesting player on this team will be Charles Gould. He came from basketball, so this is his first year doing indoor track, and after doing so well in cross country, he looks to have a good year to lead this team in indoor track. And now on to predictions.
I'm predicting the wrestling team to go over 500 and top three in the league.
I'm predicting that the girls will tie Riverdale for the league championship this year, go 17-1 in the league, have good showing in the Christmas tournament, and make it into both the county and state tournaments.
I predict the boys basketball team to go 13-5 in league, make the second round of the Jambo, and go into the second round in the state tournament.
For swimming, I predict the boys to attain a league record with the tough league that they're in to beat Riverdale and all those tough teams. And for the girls, I see them repeating as the league meet champs and a league championship.
I predict that the MVP for the wrestling team this year will be none other than Anthony Bachman.
Thank you, Dave. The girls' basketball MVP will be none other than Taylor Wooten.
For the boys' basketball team, I think Jared Holzer looks to be the MVP.
And for the MVP for swimming, I see for the boys will be Mike Lazara, and for the girls to be Kirsten Sommer.
We just have a few remaining moments on the Bulldog Beat. Does anyone have any final thoughts?
I'd just like to wish everyone good luck on their seasons, and hopefully I'll see some of you at the games, and hopefully you're all going to be part of the Bulldog Beat this year.
I'd just like to say happy holidays to everyone.
I hope to see everyone come out to my famous halftime show during boys' home games for basketball.
For Anthony Bachman, Dave Jones, and Rob Schultz, I'm Nick Macri. We look to see you back in 2007.